AeroPress coffee. Hello everybody, this is Joe Van Cleve. Welcome to my front patio courtyard. It's a beautiful autumn day. We're not going to have too many more beautiful autumn days probably. And so I'm going to try to take advantage of as many of these as I can. So I'm out here just relaxing. I spent all day tinkering with this new Lumen camera project. Well, inspired by yesterday's video where I did the comparison between a Lumen prints and conventional chemically developed paper negatives, I decided I was going to try to make a dedicated Lumen camera. And you might recall from that video, but one of the requirements of the Lumen camera is you have to have fast optics because this auto developing process of paper is rather slow. It's quite slow, in fact, so you need some fast optics. I did some experiments earlier today using an F3 binocular lens. Now, this is not a photographic quality lens in terms of corner to corner sharpness, far from it. It looks a lot more like a meniscus lens. The center of the image is sharp and the outside is soft and defocused, but it's really fast. And I got some interesting results using Ilford multi-grade contrast paper. And I pre-wetted the negatives in water and I exposed them for 20 minutes outside and I got some really good results. But what I decided was going forward I wanted to experiment with a little bit higher quality lens than the binocular lens. And so I took my Kodak Ektar 127mm f4.7 lens that I had put into a camera obscura box. It was a project I did earlier this year. And that kind of tied up that lens for being used for anything else. Well, that's my fastest 4x5 lens, f4.7. So I basically dismantled that little foam core and gaffer's tape project of the camera obscura and I had to find a camera box that I could use for this new Lumen camera project, and what I ended up finding was a wooden craft box that I had purchased a few years ago at Hobby Lobby, and I had converted it to a pinhole camera. Well, looking at the size of it and the focal length of the lens, it looked like it would be compatible. So I spent most of the morning converting that little pinhole camera to use my Kodak Ektar lens. And I currently have the first test print exposing right there, pointed at my sunny courtyard chair scene. It has an image format size of 4¾ inches, at least in this initial test of it. I may be doing some more modifications to the design, but this is a real early, primitive, crude, quickly cobbled together project. And I documented most of the build of it with my little Ape Man, my GoPro clone camera. So let's cut to that footage and you can get an idea of what I did to make this camera. Okay, we're in my dark room and I have several things I want to look at. First of all, I have some miscellaneous photo paper in these envelopes. So I have some paper to experiment with, but look at this. There's a whole pile of pinhole cameras and different kinds of cameras. And I'm not sure which one of these box cameras would be ideal for conversion to a lens camera for the binocular lens Lumen print. The problem is it has to be the right focal length for the lens and it has to be slightly water resistant from the inside. I was wanting to show you this pinhole camera. This is made from a craft box that I got at Hobby Lobby. It's a wooden box with a lid. It has a little bit of a light trap kind of a thing going on, but I had converted it to a pinhole camera years ago. It's a really nice camera and I hate to tear it up, but I'm thinking, so there is a spacer in here made of foam core that spaces that insert box to the right distance. So with an empty box like that, if you put the lid on it, it turns out that my Kodak Ektar 127 f4.7, fairly fast, Speed Graphic lens If you mount it just slightly to the front of the box like that, it'll have enough focus draw for a decent imaging. And I'm thinking for variable focus, if you put some kind of a foam core sleeve like this, it has to be longer than this, but you get the idea, and you have a 4.5 inch roughly image size with a piece of paper stuck back here, then you can insert this and it would be able to focus in and out like that. So it would focus like a nested box camera. So all I need to do is cut an opening for the lens on the front, have some spacers to space it out appropriately enough for infinity focus, and then have sufficient range of motion on this focusing sleeve made of foam core to be able to focus close up. Well, I've made a start of making a black foam core insert, and so it's designed to go all the way to the front inside the box like that, so you'll be able to focus the camera simply by pulling the lid in and out. So what I'm going to do now is I'm going to hot glue gun these inner joints together, and I normally would wrap the outside corners in gaffer's tape, but it would mean that this would not slide smoothly. The tape would interfere with the sliding. Okay, via the magic of hot glue gun, I managed to glue gun the four inner corners, and now this thing will snugly move in and out. And it'll go all the way out to like this, so I have quite a bit of close focus capability on this. Well, I'm designing this as I'm going, and I'm thinking I probably don't want to glue the back permanently to the sliding part because I want to gain access to the rear of this, and I'll show you why here. What I'm thinking is that if I could fix a temporary piece of translucent paper to the back of this, I could actually focus the lens on the tripod or wherever it's mounted on the scene, and then I would put the piece of photo paper in the back here and slip it onto the camera, such as this, something like that, with this preset to a certain distance, and then I'd be able to do my exposure. I mean, that's one idea I'm thinking. So, okay, so I just removed the shutter from the camera that was just held on by two nuts. And I'll patch that hole, but I'm going to take the pinhole out, and I'm going to get a hole saw and drill a hole in here big enough that I can mount my lens to. And I'm going to mount it flush, I think, because I have enough focus draw with this new insert that I'll be able to get infinity focus plus close-up, I think. So the pinhole was held in place by a piece of gaffer's tape, which sticks pretty darn good. Okay, we peeled off a little bit of the coating, but there's the pinhole, there's my opening, and I'll go set up a hole saw and drill a hole. So I'm going to put this hole saw, this is just under 1.5 inches. So, the problem I have with this, of course, is that the hole in the camera, centering it, is going to be a problem. So, the trick is immobilizing. Okay, now for the shop vac. Okay, there is the lens. It's pretty much sitting flush. And you can see the back of the lens, the back flange, has enough room to fit in there. So I'm going to have to figure out how to mount this. I might have to do some strips of either plywood or just foam core for now. Or just tape it. I don't know. Something simple like that. Well, back to the old drawing board, it turns out that with the lens set on the front of it, it never gets short enough of a focal length to actually get infinity focus. So, I think I can mount the lens inside the box. And then I'll be able to get infinity focus, hopefully. Okay, first of all, look how cool that lens looks flush mounted on the front of that. Now, this plastic homemade focusing screen I used in the camera obscura box that I was using that same lens in, but look, if I set this on the back now, look at that. I have infinity focus, I can focus back and forth. I just need to mount the lens board more permanently in there so it doesn't move. Okay, when I put the lens board inside the box with the front of the lens facing toward the front of the box, there's a big gap underneath it, and you lose access to the shutter mechanism. Now, the lens barrel fits pretty snugly around this hole that I cut, actually surprisingly snugly, but the board is still loose. You can still rotate it and move it like this, and I'm not really sure how I'm going to secure it, but there is an alternative. This is a symmetrical lens design, and it gets a pretty good image backwards. So if I mounted the lens backwards, you can see that I can, first of all, grab it real easy. Secondly, the lens board itself is going to be more flush with the front of the box, so I can simply secure it with gaffer's tape. Thirdly, I gain access to the shutter mechanism, so I can close the shutter or adjust apertures if I wanted to. I probably wouldn't, but in any event, doing it this way, you'll have to center the lens right there, and I'll probably have to paint the edge of that cutout dark. Doesn't look quite as good on the front, but I think it's a more practical solution. So that's probably what I'm going to do, is I'm going to have this lens mounted backwards in the box. Now, another thing having the lens flush with the inside of the box is that I will have to make a bigger shutter plate, but I'm going to go back and reinstall this nut and these two nuts and this screw. I'm going to make a bigger pivoting shutter, so the lens's shutter will be fixed in an open position, and I'll have a little sliding shutter to actually do the exposure. So it'll be kind of cool. Well, here's a shoddily done paint job. Some kind of bronze colored paint, but anyways, so there's my little shutter, and from the inside you can see that it seals up nicely, and there's the double locking screws. Now I can set the Ektar lens in backwards like that. The only issue now is that the hardware makes this side of the lens board sit up, so I'm going to have to put a spacer on the other side to space it properly. This is what happens when you don't plan things ahead of time. You build it completely ad hoc. It's going to be sitting like that, so I'm going to have to put some black foam core strips all around the lens board to seal up the light. All right, I got some spacers of foam core and gaffer's tape along the back surface of the lens board, and a little gap for the nut and screw that protrudes. So, flip this around. So it goes right down in there like that. And then I'm going to center the lens onto the hole, and then secure the lens in place with more gaffer's tape inside there. Okay, there is the lens board, somewhat secured. You can see I'm using that double-sided white tape, so I'm going to have to probably put some kind of brackets in there, hooks or something to screw into the front surface of the wood. But the trick on this is the little gap between the wall and the lens board has to accommodate the foam core, so there's not much room in there. So I haven't perfected how I'm going to use this camera, but my initial idea is it'll be sitting on a board, probably bungee corded to a board that itself is connected to a tripod. And you just put this piece of acrylic plastic that has the front side sanded down into a makeshift ground glass. You put it right there and you can focus the image. Anyway, you can focus the image on the camera by sliding this sleeve, this insert sleeve, in and out. And then when you have it set to the focus you like in your composition, you take the back of the camera, and it measures approximately, inside dimensions are 4 3/4 square. So I'm thinking I'll have photo paper cut to 4 3/4 inch square. I stick it in the back there, and then I just put the back of the lid on like that. And then around front on the camera, of course, you would operate the shutter, take your lumen exposure. We'll see what happens. Well, I'm going to shoot a picture of this little chair scene, brightly lit with the lumen box. I have it on a piece of wood that has a tripod mount, a couple hook eyes, and a bungee cord. So let me take the box off here. And my piece of acrylic plastic, I have my image focused. You probably can't see it, but my image is focused there on the ground glass. I can see it pretty good. So I'm going to go in and load up a sheet of paper in this lid, and I'll be back out. Okay, well, that was real interesting. So getting this film put in, the paper put in the back, I had to put a strip behind it so I have something to pull it off with, because it sits in a recessed well and you can't get around it with your fingers to get it off. So I had to, and then I had to carry it against my chest to keep light from getting into it. And then I, of course, moved the slider. So there's going to have to be a way to secure this better for focusing. So this is all strictly experimental, but I'm going to leave it here for about a half an hour. Should be plenty of sun on my scene over there, and we'll see what happens. Okay, this is Joe, and hopefully we'll have ourselves an interesting lumen print. Well, it's almost an hour on my timer. I've given this an hour. So the previous print with the F3 binocular lens for 30 minutes was a pretty good density negative. And I figured with F4.7, I'd give it twice the exposure. So it's been an hour out here. Okay. Let's see what we got here. So, here's the back of it. I'm gonna pop it loose. Now, I wasn't sure if the focus had slipped on this camera. I wasn't sure. Oh, it looks like it's out of focus. It looked like it slipped inside the box or my focusing slipped, but it is definitely a pretty good tones. So, out of focus, but it looks like it's fast enough for an hour's exposure time. So I had designed this box with this inner foam core sleeve that extends all the way near the front, and it moves in and out like that for focusing. And the idea was to cut a piece of paper that's large enough to fit almost to the edge, and then it would be captured on the inside of the lid when you put the lid on. But obviously there's not enough of a flange surface here to hold the paper tight, so I'm going to have to build a little window, make the size of the image smaller, maybe like 4 inches square, have a 3/8 border coming in on either side, cut the paper to 4 3/4. The foam core window will be attached to the back of this permanently with a hole here, and then you just lay the print paper on top of that and then set the back on to hold it in place. And of course, what attracted me to this decorator box at Hobby Lobby in the first place was the cinema themed decor of it, and the fact that the lid has this little lip that looks like a light trap, which it actually works as a pretty good light trap. And it's already painted black, so thought it was pretty cool. And it looks like it's going to work okay as a lens camera, a lumen box camera. So we'll see if we can make it work better this next time. Well, so I made this flange along the back of the camera out of foam core and some gaffer's tape, and I focused an image of the neighboring house up there that's still sunnily lit. I don't know if I have enough daylight left for a full hour's exposure, but I'm going to try one. So I have to cut the paper to 4 inches wide by 4 1/4 inches tall. and I can get four of those from an 8x10 sheet of paper. So I'm going to go ahead and cut some paper and load it up. All right, there's the paper sitting in the little slip there, and then I'm going to try to put this back on. All right, and now we will open the shutter. Well, it's been an hour, and this is probably the last image I'm going to make today, just because it's getting to be 4 o'clock or so in the afternoon, running out of light. But take the platform off. Now this print's probably going to be damp inside here still. I'm going to take the back off. I don't know what we're going to have. Let's see what we get. Ooh, interesting. Let's see if I can focus on here. So it definitely has the roof line of the neighboring house and the shadow of the trees, but there's a lot of streaking from apparently the water unevenness. There's an interesting thing going on right here. So anyways, it'll be fun to scan that and see what it looks like. It looks very interesting. Well, today I made a number of test exposures with lumen prints, and I started out with my Speed Graphic, and the first lenses I tried was the binocular lens, the F3 binocular lens, and I actually got a really good exposure. This was 20 minutes in bright sun with the print pre-wetted. Let me see if I can get you a good focus on this, but I'm really excited about that. That looks really cool. There's some really good tones there. I'll be showing you the scans of these in a moment. And then I did a test exposure for, I think this was an hour. And this was really good. I was really pleased with it. And again, this paper is the Ilford Multigrade Resin Coated Warm Tone Luster Finish. Well, let me show you now a little slideshow of several of the images that I created today with the lumen prints. These have been scanned. They've been inverted to positives, and of course the tones, the color tone inverts. And I've opted to keep all three of these with the color in them instead of converting them to monochrome. So they are going to be sort of bluish green, cyanish colored. But let's take a look at the slideshow. I hope you guys enjoy this. Well, this was a very experimental day. I hope this gave you some inspiration to pursue the lumen prints. So in conclusion for today, you have to kind of get a camera configured with a fast lens, a way to load paper into the camera wet, and then you have to figure out the whole scanning part. I'm still working on that, but I'm doing better. I am able to get a little bit of an image that I like. I think I'm going to stick with the colored images for a while and see what happens with that, inverting the tones. But anyways, I hope you guys found this interesting, and until next time, you guys have yourselves a great day.